dear students, we will start a new chapter, that is measures of central tendency or average. It is a part of your statistics, so we will be continuing this chapter. So this chapter is familiar to you because you have learned this, I think, in class 10 in mathematics. So in this chapter we study about mean, median and mode. So first we will see about mean. So under mean you have to study individual series, discrete series and continuous series. So one by one we need to see what is individual series, what is discrete series and what is continuous series. Now when we talk about individual series, you can see that individual series means a numbers will be given 26, 27, 28, 29 and it goes on. Okay, so this is individual series. You can see only one chain of number will get in the question. When we talk about discrete series, in discrete series you will get two values of x and we will get frequency. Suppose x you will get, same number I am taking, 26, 27, 28 and you will get frequency like 1, 2, 3. So this is called discrete series. Now when we talk about continuous series, it looks like suppose 20 to 30, 30 to 40, then 40 to 50 and frequency will be given. Okay, this is called class interval. Okay, these are called class intervals and frequency will be given 1, 2, 3 and it goes on. So this way mean is classified into three types: individual series, discrete series and continuous series. So one by one we will discuss. So we will talk about discrete series. Individual series is very easy, like average. Suppose if I give to find mean of 26, 27, 28 and 29. So what you will do, simply you will add and divide by number of observations. Suppose if I say find the mean of 26, 27, 28 and 29. So what you will do, you will plus 26 plus, you will add this and you will divide by 1, 2, 3, 4, divide by 4. So this is individual series, it is simply like average. So we will talk about discrete series. So in discrete series, you have to study two methods, direct method and shortcut method. So on the direct method, the formula for finding mean, that is x bar, we denote mean by x bar, is summation fx by summation f, clear? And in shortcut method, to find mean, we use this formula, x bar equal to a plus summation fd by summation f. A means assume mean. So first let us see one question of direct method. Now we'll do one question of mean by direct method. So under direct method, the formula for finding mean is summation fx by summation f. Now what is summation? Summation means total. Summation means total. So we require summation fx and summation f to find mean. So let us see what is, how to find fx, summation fx. Now here you have x and you have, here you have f. So what you need to do, first you need to find fx. Fx means f multiplied by x. So 1 multiplied by 20 will be 20, 2 multiplied by 21 will be 42, then 4 into 22 will be 88 and 23 into 5 will be 15, 13, 11. So 115 and 24 into 15 will be 360 and 25 into 23 will be 575. Clear students? Now what you need to do, you need to find a total. When we find total of fx, we call it summation fx, and we find, when we find a total of summation f, we call that summation f. So when we total it, 1 plus 2 plus 4 plus 5 plus 15 plus 23 will get 50, clear? And when we total this one, 20, 42, 88, 115, 360, 575, we will get 1200. So we got summation fx 1200 and summation f 50. So let us substitute the values. So summation fx is 1200 and summation f will be 50, as we got here, summation f and summation fx. So when we divide, you will get 24. So mean equals to 24. Clear? Now let us do this question with shortcut method. So students will do this same question with the help of shortcut method. So on the shortcut method, the formula to find mean is a plus summation fd by summation f. So this is the formula to find mean by shortcut method. Now what is a? A new thing you can see here, a. So a is assumed mean. What we'll do, we'll take one assumed mean from x series. So we'll take 23. Okay, so better to take a middle term. Okay, 23 I'm taking it. So d, so d is also a new thing for you. So for what, how to find d? D is x minus a. Now this x series you can see here, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. So to find d, what you will do, you will subtract x minus a. Suppose 20 minus 23, 21 minus 23, 22 minus 23, 23 minus 23, 24 minus 23, 25 minus 23. So let us follow the step, let us see how it is done. Right. 20 minus 23 will be minus 3. Don't ignore minus, okay? Then 21 minus 23 minus 2, 22 minus 23 minus 1, 23 minus 23 0, 24 minus 23 1, and 25 minus 23 will be 2. So this way we got d series. Now what you need to do, you need to find summation fd. So we require fd, so we'll prepare one more column of fd. So how to find fd? Means f multiplied by d. So 1 into minus 3 will be minus 3, 2 into minus 2 will be minus 4, 4 into minus 1 will be minus 4, 5 into 0 will be 0, 15 into 1 will be 15, and 23 minus 2 will be 46. So this way we got fd. So when we total this one, we will get summation fd. So what is the total of summation fd? When you total it, you will get 50. Clear students? Now again, if we total, summation f will get 50, as same as in the previous question. So we got summation f and summation fd. So let us substitute the values in the formula. So a was 23, our assumed mean. Now summation fd we got 50 and summation f was 50. Clear? Now when we divide it, we'll get 1. So x bar equal to 23 plus 1, so that is 24. Remember students, when you are doing mean by direct method, shortcut method, the answer you'll get is the same, only formula is different and the working is different. So that's all for today. Thank you.